Well, we're getting a first look at the proposed budget for Greenville County Schools, and it includes some of the issues teachers are marching for in Columbia tomorrow.
The budget total is more than $668 million. It's based in part on funding from the state that isn't approved just yet, though. One of the main highlights, raises for teachers at entry level, including starting teacher pay at $40,000. All teachers with up to 2 years experience will be bumped up to that salary. All teachers with 3 to 30 years will get a 5 to 9% increase. Also in the budget, a minimum 30-minute planning period every day for every teacher.
The proposal includes reducing first grade class size ratios from 19 to 1 to 18 to 1, 18 students to one teacher. The budget does come with a mill increase, which for a business would cost between $8 and $20 per month. For a brand new car, 75 cents per month, and an older car, 10 cents per month. The district also responded to the timing of the budget release, coming just a day before the scheduled teacher rally, saying this was planned in advance.
The timing is accidental, if you will. This budget meeting had been scheduled for a very long time. It is interesting that it kind of falls a day before this rally in Columbia. So we really hope our teachers have received this information. It's been sent out to them. We hope they have an opportunity to take a look at it and see what our superintendent is proposing for them, what he's fighting for.
The school board will host a public hearing on the budget coming up on May 21st.
Well, meantime, teachers all across the state are demanding to be heard, some saying they've had enough and want lawmakers to make major changes. This past year, a group of educators say they've written letters telling legislators their class sizes are just too big. Now, that's just one of the many complaints, but low pay and no true lunch break are also major factors leading to tomorrow's rally on the State House grounds.
Fox Carolina's Kayla Conboy says teachers say they're standing united and they're ready to form a united front for change, though the outcome is still up in the air.
They're calling it All Out May 1st, a day of reflection, and one protester says it's stemming from a culmination of events.
We didn't want it to come to this, but every conventional method we have tried, and the sort of reform that we want to pursue is not being made available by our legislator.
Natalie Argueta is an upstate representative for SC for Ed. She says in the past year they've been sending letters, making phone calls, and speaking at town halls, all to make their point.
We are united in our frustrations. We are concerned about class sizes being too big. We're concerned with the base student costs that, you know, our students are given legally in the Education Finance Act of 1977 not being met by $533 per student.
She says they want change and think a reform can happen if they all stand together. Some districts in the upstate say they're gearing up to be low on staff. Pickens County saying they have 43 teachers requesting the day off, and Greenville County reporting 128 plan on using a personal day.
Class size, teacher salary, mental health for students, over testing for students. In order for all of those issues to be addressed with our students, we have to take a deep look at those issues.
But others feel a different way. There have been hot takes, with some saying it's abandoning a classroom, your students, if you walk. The state superintendent sending a statement saying, "I cannot support teachers walking out on their obligations to South Carolina students, families, and the thousands of hardworking bus drivers, cafeteria workers, counselors, aides, and custodial staff whose livelihoods depend on our schools being operational." Despite the divide, some teachers are excited to march, united. And certain legislators, like Senator Floyd Nicholson, say it's something that's really needed.
There have not been many changes in the education reform bill in many years, and it's something that needs to be done, because we got to make sure that we have teachers in the classroom that are prepared and that we compensate teachers adequately. And the main thing is recruiting young people to go into the educational field.
Kayla Conboy, Fox Carolina News.